All right. All right. First, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 open mic people. I have time for them to have a little more time than usual. I usually give them 3 minutes. Today, I'm giving them 5. So you can have up to 5. And I may even let you stretch it to 6. Anyway, the first one up is Ruth Kozak. Ruth just moved to New Westminster. She loves it here, so let's give her a nice, warm New Westminster welcome.
Today what I'm going to do is going to read first a poem by a Greek poet friend, Chris Belisario. Chris is a professor of physics, specialized in space physics, candidate doctor of anti-education, prized by the Ministry of Education in Greece. She's an activist for peace, world poetry, Canada, and international ambassador to Greece in 2014-2016. And she was first International Beat Poet Laureate 2018 in the USA and has published more than 300 poems on her blogs. Chris invited, my first volume of my novel Shadow of the Lion was published in 2014. Chris, who's in charge of the world poetry in Larissa, Greece, she invited me there for a conference they were having to introduce my book. So I've met her in person, and she's on Facebook. So this is one of her poems called Fight Arrogance, Do Die Without Sorrow. All this love, which I cannot even bear, all this endless worship, all this game with death, a moth with black wings became a prey to the light, to approach for a while and extinguish with it. Falling onto it. Who the hell am I, me, to uproot the stars from the skies? Who the hell am I to go against the waves? Who am I to offend the sacred? The one I am. I'm the one I am. I cannot be other way. I give, I engage myself, I'm strong. I spend myself for what I crave. Sacrifice for the ones I became. When I fall in love with life, I catch fire falling on it. Inspiration. I guess I do not have much time. The gods punish arrogance. Cut the life's thread earlier, said my ancestors. Let's get drunk then, with what's left. Do not leave me alone. I crawl toward you as a humble supplicant. Come with me. Time is running out. For how long, malevolent Atropos will sharpen her scissors? You, do you hear me? Cut my thread. I want to go first. I own my fate. One thing I know, I don't need to wear, but most of all, I know how to live. That's why I can even die without fear. I'm walking toward you in the open arms, without any shield, want to trust you. My imperishable body is full of wounds, bleeding but so sweet because of love. I look at you in the eyes, stranger. Hit, I can stand it, waiting for you. Belief in you from the beginning, I'm still vulnerable, but no defense. In my life's path, I will always risk to know you as friend, fully uncovered. I do not follow any precautions, won't lose what I'm able to be, innocent. I will welcome you unrepentantly, as much as the pain, more will be joy. My caring smile brought you by my side, and like a tree branch to your winds blow, bending, not breaking. I need your breath, my unknown brother, just to experience wisdom and happiness, your approach. I won't confine you to any limit. Looking forward to your open-minded, I accept, I hope, you'll bring the light. It's just me, it's just you, that children, let us play again in the same yard. So that's Chris's poem. And this poem is one that one of my own. This is one of my own that was just published in an anthology. anthology in the States, and it was specifically an anthology about poems to do with the current situation in the world with refugees and displaced people. And all the proceeds from the anthology were going toward a refugee organization. This was written on the beach at Naxos a couple of years ago. And it's dedicated to a little boy, I think his name is Alan. And actually, I think his relatives live in Surrey. It's called Precious Moments on the Beach. On the beach at Naxos, it isn't just the mothers who care for their children. I see fathers tenderly cradling babies, rocking them gently as they pace the shore. Another holds his tiny daughter tight. A mother holds her toddler's hand on their morning stroll. Here on Naxos, sun-browned naked nymphs frolic at the water's edge. Children everywhere romp in the summer sun. Happy families together on the beach. On another island, a child's limp body is lifted from the sand. The shoreline strewn with abandoned life jackets, backpacks, and debris. A father grieves for his drowned family. A mother screams in terror. These parents care for their children too, have risked their lives to escape to a safe place, leaving the horrors of war behind, to crowd onto overloaded rubber rafts for a sea journey to safety. How many of them have drowned on the voyage? How many have lost their children? Those children they wanted to bring to a safe shore, to enjoy a future in a place where there was no war. On Lesbos Island, it isn't just fish the sailors catch in their nets. Brave men dive into the sea to save those who are floundering. Village women bring warm blankets, food, offer comfort. Strangers come from afar to embrace the rescued ones. Yet there are those who would not welcome them. Go back home, they say. Home? There is no home. It has all been destroyed, and already too many lives lost. I sit on Naxos shore, watch the happy parents stroll, hear the happy cries of children, and I think about that island not too far from here, where a frightened mother cradles her baby and a father cries for a drowned son.